Before you continue to the next lesson, I'd like to encourage you to take a minute to set up a Git workspace that will work well for you. If you take the time to configure a few things about Git, it can be much easier and more pleasant to use. My configuration includes this custom prompt, which shows my username in purple and what directory I'm in blue. Having it more colorful like this just makes it stand out more from the other commands. Now if I cd into a directory with a Git repository, I also have this in green, which shows what commit I currently have checked out. Right now it's just showing the commit ID, but in lesson 2 you'll see how to give commits names, and this will become more useful. This prompt will also show a star if I've made any changes since committing. So if I were to open up game.js and add another line, then you see a star here, which indicates that I have changes that haven't been committed. I'm just going to undo that. So now the star is gone. I also have tab completion set up, so I can type just the first few characters of a Git command, for example git l, and press tab, and the rest of the command will be completed automatically. There are also some situations where Git will open up a text editor. For example, as you'll see in the next lesson, when you make a commit, Git opens an editor for you to write a commit message. You'll want to set this editor to whatever you prefer to use.